identify those whose vision could be improved by optical aids, and to study improvement in function and to understand the pattern of blindness. The team has been a part of several such studies in the past, and earlier studies from Maharashtra, Karnataka, Delhi, Andhra, the northeastern states have shown that many children in schools for the blind have some amount of residual vision. But for the first time, we did a detailed comprehensive ocular examination using a handheld slit lamp and a fundus camera. We did visual fields. And what we did differently this time was we looked at assessment of vision function. That is, after doing a thorough refraction, anybody who has slightest vision, we used Galilean telescope for distance, we used magnifiers, spectacle magnifiers, bar magnifiers for near trial, and we used L.V. Prasada Institute's functional vision questionnaire. Then children who could improve, we give them specs and low vision aids. And after 6 months, after giving these devices, we did a follow-up, and again the questionnaire was asked to each and every individual student, and the pre and post rating was compared. And we had used the Vijaya Gothwal's questionnaire, which is standardized questionnaire. So there were 428 students enrolled in four schools for the blind, half of whom were boys. And again, to our surprise, we found that only one third of them really were absolutely blind, that this they had no light perception. The rest of the children had a small amount of vision. When we looked at the causes of blindness, congenital anomalies are of course the commonest cause of blindness, followed by corneal diseases, retinal dystrophies, and then cataract. 54 students were dispensed low vision aid and spectacles because we thought they would improve, and the specs power ranged from plus 10 to minus 22, or the cylinder from minus 7 to plus 1.75. Some were given only specs, some were given LVA for distance, LVA for near, or others were given LVAs for distance and near. Again, these are the LVAs that are given: telescopes and dome magnifiers, stand magnifiers, hand magnifiers. And well, to our great surprise, and we were very happy to see that almost 26 of them could identify letters or numbers after giving them some kind of a magnifier. When we gave them specs and low vision aids, 24 actually improved to more than 6 by 60. Three more had their vision improved from 360 to 660. So 27 out of 54, almost 50% of those children were no longer legally blind after they were helped. Then we asked the LVP functional vision questionnaire, do you have any difficulty in making out whether the person you are seeing across the road is a boy or a girl during the day? It's improved. The higher the score, the poorer their vision. The lower the score, the better is their vision. Do you have any difficulty in seeing whether somebody is calling you by waving his or her hand across the road? The score has improved.
15 minutes more.
It's not improved for bumping in corridors, but do you have any difficulty in walking home at night? Do you have any difficulty in copying from the blackboard while sitting on the first bench of the class? Or difficulty in reading bus numbers or the destination of the bus? Or difficulty in reading your textbooks at the arm's length? All of them had greatly improved. Do you have difficulty in writing along a straight line? Has improved. Difficulty in finding the next line while reading when you take a break and then resume reading? So in all of this, there was a difference. There is no difference, again, in distinguishing between 1 or 2 rupee coin, or tying shoelaces, or, you know, locating a big ball, or applying toothpaste, or trying to identify food items. We also did a comparison because we have been studying these schools for the blind for almost last 16 years. And we find that anophthalmos and microphthalmos still is the main common cause of blindness. But retinopathy of prematurity, which was not seen in the earlier series, is now being seen for the first time. So what has changed? Congenital whole globe anomalies and enigma still remain the commonest cause of blindness. Well, it could be an environmental risk factors, or there could be a maternal vitamin A deficiency, or there could be a combination of this, we don't know, but they are still the commonest causes in the country. Retinal dystrophies are a significant cause. In fact, in the Karnataka series, that's the maximum, the leading cause of blindness. This time, operable cataracts were less, but operated ones were more, perhaps because of comorbidity and amblyopia. Retinopathy of prematurity is now being seen, and nystagmus and optic nerve disorders remain. So nutritional causes, infective causes of childhood blindness are declining, while congenital anomalies and genetic causes are relatively more on the rise. So even so-called blind children have residual vision that can be put to use. They can be taught to read normal print rather than Braille, and this will increase their social and professional avenues. Because if you learn Braille, maximum you can become a Braille teacher. But if you can read and write print, English, Roman letters, or Devanagari, then there is so much more that a child can do. So repeated ocular examination, low vision assessment must be made mandatory for all schools for the blind in India and across the world. We have almost 2 lakh blind children in this country, less than 10,000 of which are there in schools for the blind. So even if 1/8 of them improve and get more functional vision, there is such a big contribution that we ophthalmologists have made to the community. And in the end, we have to go towards partial integrated education, not just blind school education. Thank you.
Thanks.